सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतं वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ वनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विधावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणुजातिपुरवेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेमात्मूर्तिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायान्तं संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे Is there a background noise of the fan?
Yes, but it's not bothering.
Okay, just let me switch this off. And...
No, it's okay, probably.
Okay, so I think now it should be less. Okay, so the second sutra is introduced by saying Yattu Shaktita Pravrutteshcha Iti Tatra Ah. In the Sankhya Karikas, there is one Karika which says Bhedanam Parimanat Samanvayat Shaktita Pravrutteshcha Karanakarya Vibhagat Avibhagat Vaishwarupyasya. So there, a part of that is quoted by the Vritti saying that Yattu Shaktita Pravrutteshcha. What it means is that the karana of all karyas is avyakta pradhana. Why? The karika says, Sankhya karika says, bhedana parimanat. Because karyas are limited, because of their being limited. And then samanvayat, because the cause is connected to all the karyas, the karana is connected, and shaktitah pravrutteshcha, due to the karya being produced due to the shakti of the karana, the karya, the pravrutti there is due to the shakti of the karana, that is shaktitah, karanasya shaktitah pravrutteshcha. Karya is created by the shakti of the karana, that is the Sankhya Karika itself. And then also because vibhaga and avibhaga is from the karana, the karya vibhaga is from the karana, and then avibhaga meaning merging is also into the same karana pradhana. This is what the Sankhya Karika says. So there the sutrakara replies by saying Pravrutteshcha, Pravrutteshcha. So he says that the same word, Shaktitah Pravrutteshcha, in the Sankhya Karika, you look at that Pravrutti. What is that Pravrutti due to? So Pravrutti becomes the Karana. Pravruttehe is Heto Panchami. Pravruttehe cha, due to the Pravrutti, Pravrutteshcha Chetana Adhinatva Darshanat Pradhanam Jagat Karanam Na Bhavati. That is Sutrartha. Because of the pravritti, you see only chetana can have pravritti. So karana becoming karya, that kind of a pravritti is there only if the karana, that kind of a pravritti is possible only if the karana is chetana vastu, not achetana vastu like pradhana. Therefore that itself becomes the hetu, pravritti itself becomes the hetu to counter your sankhya karika itself. So pravrutteshcha, and that pravrutti, the shakti also is what? It is chetana adhina. The shakti cannot be for an insentient thing. The shakti is leading to pravrutti, all right, but that shakti and pravrutti both are not independent. They are dependent on the chetana vastu, purusha in your case, says the Vedanti.
Thereby,
the Pradhana, which is Achetana, cannot be independent Karana for the Prapancha. Lokehi Achetana Rathadi Pravruttehe Chetana Adhinatva Darshanat. Whether you say the Karana becomes Karya, that is the Pravrutti, or Karya, also you see there is some Pravrutti in the Karya, all that is seen in the world, such as Rathadi. So Ratha is Achetana, your Pradhana is Achetana, the Karya is definitely Achetana. So Karana Karya both being Achetana, they will have dependency on the Chetana Vastu for their Pravrutti. So Achetana Rathadi Pravrutti He. Ratha also can move on the path only when there is Chetana driving it. So whether it is a charioteer who is moving it, or you have horses which are being driven by the horses themselves are Chetana, or horses which are guided by, or even not guided also, they can pull the chariot, but you need something Chetana. Chetana Adhinatva Darshanat. This has been seen that there is a dependency of all Achetanas to move on Chetana. There is a dependency. Pradhanasya Samyavastha Prachyuti Rupa Pravruttehe Chetana Prerana Mantrena Anupapattehe Ityartha. So here, what is the Pravrutti which is being discussed? The Pradhana has the Pravrutti of becoming the Karya. Therefore, Pradhana is Karana, said the Sankhya Karika. Now, what is this Pravrutti? At the end of the Kalpa and before the beginning of the another Kalpa, that time there is a Samyavastha of Gunas. So Samyavastha, Gunanam Samyavastha. So that Samyavastha, which is when there is no Srishti, that goes out of imbalance. So Samyavastha Prachyuti Rupa. Prachyuti is Prakarshachyuti. There is a fall from the Samyavastha. When the Gunas are in balance, that time there is no Srishti. So there is a fall from that balance of the Gunas, that is called as Prachyuti, meaning imbalance. So the Samyavastha becoming Asamya, the Gunas which are balanced equally, when they go out of balance and there is an imbalance, that time there is a Srishti. So that Prachyuti Rupa Pravrutti is the Pravrutti. Prachyuti is the form, Rupa of that Pravrutti, and due to that Pravrutti, Pradhana is Karana, said the Purvapakshi. So Samyavastha Prachyuti Rupa Pravruttehe Chetana Prerana Mantarena Anupapatte. Due to impossibility, Anupapatti of this Prachyuti of Samyavastha of the Pradhana, without Chetana Prerana, without the Purusha giving Prerana, Chaitanya Purusha giving Prerana to Pradhana as to falling out of imbalance, falling out of balance into imbalance, and thereby Srishti taking place, without that kind of a Prerana it is not possible. Therefore Pradhana is dependent on Purusha, and that is the reason that Pradhana cannot be considered as Karana. So Pradhanam na Karanam ityartha. Anyatra Vyavicharam Ashankya Pariharati. Now, what the Purvapakshi is saying, that there is such Vyabhichara elsewhere you see that without Prerana from Chetana also, there is a possibility, we see possibility of change Pravrutti in Achetana. So thereby the next sutra comes up, Payombuvacche Tatrapi. Payombuvacche Tatrapi. So the example is Payo Ambuvat Chet Tatra Api. So Payas is milk, Kshira. Ambu is water. So the Purvapakshi says that there is no dependency of the milk when it flows from the mother cow to the calf. We have seen in this, in the world, the milk from the mother flows to the calf on its own. There is no chetana pravritti there. So achetana pravritti is possible. There is no adhinatvam. And ambuvat, like jala, the water also flows. The river flows, Ganga is flowing. Is Ganga flowing with a chetana prerana? It is not. Says the Purvapakshi, the river water is flowing without any prerana, without any chetana adhinatvam. Similarly, here also pradhana may have pravritti of going out of imbalance of sattva, rajas and tamas and becoming this prapancha, become the karana for this prapancha. How about that? So iti chet tatrapi, there also there is a dependency on chetana. How so? So there the siddhanti is saying payombuvat chet, payombuvat chet tatrapi. The claim of the Purvapakshi is still payombuvat chet. So payombuvat chet, what is that? Payombuvat cha achetanasya pradhanasya swayameva pravruttehe. That is the Purvapaksha iti chet. So tatrapi, tatrapi chetana adhinatvat na pradhanam jagat karanam. Why? How is there prerana there? So that we will see in the vritti. Nanu achetanasya swayam pravruttir drishyate. Achetana has pravritti on its own without any dependency on chetana, without any dependency on sentient being. Insentient also can have some activity. Yathakshiram payasis kshira. So yathakshiram vatsavivruddhaye swayameva pravartate. I have marked this as shiram because payas word has not been used in the sutra. Payas word has not been used in the vritti, but the equivalent word has been used. Similarly, jalam here. I have marked those because otherwise there is nothing to mark in the vritti as the mula. So yathakshiram vatsavivruddhaye swayameva pravartate. The milk from the mother moves to the offspring on its own. Why? The only reason that the milk is moving is for the vriddhi, vriddhi of the vatsa, of the child, of the calf, of the offspring. So the mother's milk is moving on its own, swayameva pravartate. Similarly, pradhana also can have pravritti on its own without any dependency on chaitanya. Yathava jalam swayameva syandate, or the water flows on its own from a higher ground to lower ground. Tadvat pradhanamapi swayameva pravartata iti chet. Similarly, pradhana also has pravritti on its own. Why not consider that aspect, that perspective? Iti chet tatrapi, there also paramatmayo preraka shruyate. Shruti is the pramana there as to how the river flows also. You may call it as gravity, but why gravity? Why only that much? Why is there a difference in gravities across planets? All this cannot be answered by scientists as to why. For each answer, there will be another why. Not every why can be answered. Pujya Swamiji used to say, however qualified a person be, an expert in any area, the best of the experts, their ignorance is only one question away. Just one question away. Whatever they can answer, you ask another question. Finally, there will be no. Just one question away. That's all. Just because you have not asked another question, you don't know anything better what to ask, does not mean that he knows everything. He or she knows everything. So their ignorance is also one question away. Not everything can be answered. Finally, you have to say that I do not know. Why so? How, maybe how can be answered, but why cannot be answered? So there paramatmayo preraka shruyate yo apsutishtan ityadina tathacha payombunaha pakshatvat navya vichara iti bhavaha. So there, why is milk flowing towards its offspring, towards the mother's offspring? Why is the water flowing, the river water flowing from the higher ground to a lower ground? For all that, paramatmayo prerakaha. There is definitely चेतन प्रेरणा देर ऑल्सो यू के नॉट सी इट श्रुति सेज सो यह अपसुतिष्ठन वन हू बीइंग विद इन द वॉटर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वॉटर मेक्स द वॉटर फ्लो वन हू इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द मिल्क हू मेक्स द मिल्क फ्लो और हू हिमसेल्फ फ्लोज एज दो सो ऑल दैट इज वॉट इज एंसर्ड बाई द श्रुति यह अपसुतिष्ठन योपसुतिष्ठन इत्यादिना तथा च पयोमनो हो सो वॉट पयस्य नंबू बीइंग इनसेंशिएंट ऑल्सो हैज प्रवृत्ति हैज बीन शोन विथ एन एग्जाम्पल बट यू कैन नॉट यूज दैट एज एन एग्जाम्पल वाई इट इज ऑल्सो पक्ष देयर ऑल्सो वेदर ऑर नॉट प्रवृत्ति इज इंडिपेंडेंट और डिपेंडेंट दैट हैज नॉट बीन असर्टेन्ड वॉट कैन बी गिवन एज एन उदाहरण यू कैन गिव दैट एज एन एग्जाम्पल इन तर्क विच इज सपक्ष वेर दी हेतु इज सीन वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स साध्य हेतु एंड साध्य बोथ शुड बी देर इन दी पक देन इट विल बिकम सपक्ष हियर दैट इट्सेल्फ इज क्वेश्चनेबल हाउ कैन यू से आई एम सेइंग दैट इट इज मूविंग ड्यू टू चेतन प्रेरणा यू आर सेइंग दैट इट इज मूविंग विदाउट एनी प्रेरणा चेतन प्रेरणा सो इट इज अ पक्ष इट इज नॉट सपक्ष इट इज नॉट समथिंग विच इज एस्टैब्लिश यू कैन नॉट यूज इट एज एन एग्जाम्पल तथा च पयंबुनो हो पक्षत्वात् बिकॉज पयस एंड अंबू इज ऑल्सो पक्ष देर फोर न व्यभिचार इति भाव देर इज नो व्यभिचार एज टू वॉट इज द व्यभिचार इन इन द सिद्धांति एज पॉइंटेड आउट बाय द पूर्व पक्ष इन द सिद्धांति स्टेटमेंट तर्क यूज एज टू वॉट वॉज दैट चेतन प्रेरणमंतरेण अनुपपत्ते सो वॉट इज बेसिकली यू कैन रीड अ तर्क देर एज टू Wherever there is achetana pravritti, all that is chetana adhina. So you should see that wherever, so yatra yatra, achetana pravritti hi, tatra tatra chetana prerana. Therefore, in this, there is an exception shown by the Purvapakshi. Without the Chetana, Prerana also, the milk and the water is flowing. Therefore, Achetana Pravrutti Yatra Yatra, Tatra Tatra Chetana Preranam is not working. Says the Purvapakshi, that is the Vyabhichara. You cannot show that. And what is the example he has used? Yatha Payombu. सो पयोम्बुवच्च सो यथा पयोम्बुनोः प्रवृत्तिः और प्रवृत्ति इन द्विवचन बट ही कैनॉट यूज दैट टू शो व्यभिचारा बिकॉज दे आर ऑल्सो पक्ष अंतर्गत आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू मेन्शन वन थिंग इन द लास्ट पाठ द फर्स्ट सूत्र आई डिंट एक्सप्लेन द सुखादीनाम आंतरत्व प्रतिपत्ति है आई जस्ट सेड दैट देर इज अ प्रतीति मात्र एंड प्रतीति मात्र डज नॉट शो सत्यत्व ऑफ सुख सो सुख दुख And moha pratiti is there in the prapancha, but sukha dukha and moha are not really there in the prapancha. But this word, what is this word saying itself? So pratipattehe tadanvitattvam, I had explained as tadanvitattvam is sukha dukha moha anvitattvam. So tadanvitattvam jagatha asiddham. The prapancha does not have sukha dukha moha Anvaya from the Karana. Even if the Karana Pradhana is claimed to have Sukha Dukha Moha by making equivalency with Sattva, Rajas and Tamas, still there is no Anvaya into Jagat really. Why so? Sukhadina Antaratva Pratipatti. So there I said Pratiti Matra does not prove, but this word is Hetu, which is a Pratipatti. Pratipatti is understanding. Pratipatti He. केशाम प्रतिपत्ति ही सुखा सुखादीनाम सुख दुख मोह सो सुख दुख मोह प्रतिपत्ति दि अनुभव इज वेर आंतरत्व इट इज इन दि अंतकरण वॉट एवर सुखानुभव दुखानुभव मोह इज देर ऑल दैट इज दि अंतकरण वृत्ति सो दैट अंतकरण वृत्ति विच इज विद इन लीडिंग टू सुखानुभव दुखानुभवा और मोहानुभवा इत्यादि, ऑल दीज आर एक्सटेंडेड ऑन टू द विषय आउटसाइड द शरीर थ्रू द इंद्रियाज. व्हाट यू आर सीइंग, यू एज्यूम दैट द सुख दुख इत्यादि आर इन द विषयाज, बट इट इज नॉट रियली देयर. सो आई नॉट एक्सप्लेन दिस वर्ड विद द हेतु लिटरली, सो आई जस्ट हैड टू गो बैक. But what it means is Arthata had explained that there is a pratiti of sukha outside, but it is not there in the vishaya. Sukha sukhadi pratiti is there. But where is it really? It is experience inside. Within there is a sukha anubhava, but does not mean that it is in the vishaya. And so on with the dukkha ityadi also. So anyway, with that the third sutra is also over. The fourth sutra is introduced by saying nanu evamapi dharmadyapekshaya प्रधानस्य प्रवृत्ति इत्याशंक्य आह. नाउ पूर्व पक्षी सेज इवन सो, इवन इफ देर इज अ पक्षांतर्गतत्वम ऑफ द एग्जांपल्स दैट आई गेव एज शोइंग व्यभिचार, एज टू शोइंग व्यभिचार, स्टिल देर इज स्टिल पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ प्रधाना हैविंग प्रवृत्ति इंडिपेंडेंटली. मे बी माई एग्जाम्पल्स वेर नॉट राइट, बट logically pradhana can still have pravritti without dependency on dharma, without dependency on achetana, by dependency on dharma. So nanu evamapi dharmadyapekshaya, so dharmadyapeksha is possible for pradhana, meaning chetana apeksha is not there. Achetana itself, dharma is achetana, and that dharma itself can cause the imbalance in the pradhana and thereby srishti can start, because the prapancha srishti is for the dharma adharma of the jiva. Dharma includes adharma also. The word dharma stands for adharma also. So dharma and adharma, punya papa phala should be given. That is the reason that there is a prapancha, that you also agree. The creation of the world is to give punya papa roopa phala, which is accumulated by each and every jiva. To those very jivas, the phalas have to be given, and therefore there is a srishti, which is same in your paksha also, your siddhanta also. So why do you say that pradhana has to have dependency on chetana? There can be independent srishti by pradhana by taking basis of dharma. Punya papas are achetana. Based on them, there will be srishti at the an appropriate time. An appropriate kind of srishti will be there. So how about that? Based on dharma, evam api dharmadyapekshaya, based on dharma, pradhanasya pravritti syad, pradhana can have pravritti and srishti can take place, ityashankyah. If that is the doubt, it is refuted in the fourth sutra by saying vyatirekanavastiteschanapekshatvat. So व्यतिरेक अनवस्थितेः च अनपेक्षत्वात्. सिद्धांती सेज देर इज अ धर्म अधर्म डिपेंडेंसी दैट यू आर सेइंग विच द प्रधाना कैन हैव, बट अदर देन प्रधाना बिफोर क्रिएशन व्हाट एल्स इज देयर? वन पुरुषा इज देयर हु इज चेतना, नथिंग एल्स इज देयर. वेर इज दिस धर्म अधर्म? There is nothing other than pradhana called as dharma dharma, and this purusha is asanga. Therefore asanga meaning he is neutral, he has nothing to do. Purusha has nothing to do with the srishti, he is completely independent and is not even really a karta, he is only a bhokta, he has nothing to influence pradhana also. Therefore this pravritti nivritti of pradhana into creation etc., all that is not possible. Therefore pradhana cannot be jagat karana at all. So you are sadly mistaken again, says the siddhanti. So anavasthiti, there is no vyatireka anavasthiti, there is no अवस्थिति ऑफ व्यतिरेक, प्रधान व्यतिरेक धर्म अधर्म एनीथिंग like that is not existent. There is no avasthiti of such an entity. Or multiple entities also, dharma, dharma, that is not there other than pradhana. So pradhana, vyatireka, nothing. Other than pradhana, there is nothing. So pradhana, vyatirekena, sahakari, you can say sahakari. Dharma, dharma, all of these are sahakari karana as per Purvapakshi in the Ashanka, which was given in the introduction to this sutra as to what? Dharmadi apekshaya pradhanasya pravrutti. So dharmadi apeksha is what? Dharmadi sahakari karana for pradhana to create. And there is no flaw as per the Purvapakshi, because Purvapakshi is focusing on answering the question raised by the Siddhanti as to without the Chetana, how is it possible? Chetana is definitely there. So there is a dependency on your Purusha. If you agree, then you will have compromised your Siddhanta. So Sankhya has to stick to it, saying that there is no dependency on Chetana Purusha. So he is showing there is a dependency on Dharma Adharma, which is Achetana. Then the Siddhanti is saying that Pradhana Vyatireka Dharma Adharma Sahakari Karana itself is not there. Pradhana Vyatirekena Sahakari Antarasya Anavasthite, because there is nothing other than Pradhana to become Sahakari Karana, like Dharma Adharma. And then what? Anapeksha, there is no apeksha of Chetana as per your Siddhanta. You cannot say that, okay, let there be Purusha, who is there? Purushasya tu asanga udasinatvena pravruttav nivruttavva anapekshatvat. Pradhanam na jagatkaranam. Anapekshatvat means Chetanasya Purushasya anapekshatvat. So vyatireka from Pradhana, only Purusha is there. Who is? Having no dependency in your, meaning Pradhana is having no dependency on Purusha, and Purusha has no connection with Pradhana as per your own Sankhya Karika, your own Siddhanta. Then if you say Dharma Adharma, then other than Pradhana there is nothing called as Dharma Adharma, which can become Sahakari Karana. Therefore what? Pradhana cannot be Jagat Karana. Vritti, Sankhya Mate Gunaha Samyena Avasthita Pradhanam. What is Pradhanam? Pradhanam is nothing but Sattva Rajas Tamas being in Samya Avastha. Because that is what you call as Pradhana. After that you don't have anything called Pradhana once the Srishti starts. Once the Srishti is begun, Mahat is created, then Mahat onwards, all these Indriyas, Ityadi till the end product, Prakriti has no role to play, pure Prakriti. Then Prakriti Vikritis are there, and in the end you will have only Vikritis, which are only Karyas. So Pradhana has no role to play after the three Gunas go out of balance. So before they go out of balance, that time alone there is a name called as Pradhana, and that Pradhana is what? Gunaha Samyena Avasthita. That is Pradhana. Tadvyatirekena Sahakari Antarasya Anavasthite. Other than that, there is nothing called as Dharma Adharma. So if that you will have to answer, what is this Dharma, Sattva, Rajasva, or Tamas? What is it? You cannot say that it is only Sattva, only Rajas, only Tamas. And you cannot say it's a mix-up of that also, because there is a Samya Avastha. There won't be any ups and downs in Dharma and Adharma if at all you say it is part of the Sattva, Rajas, Tamas. There is imbalance. If it is imbalance, then it's Srashta Avastha. It is not pre-Srishti. So before Srishti, where is your Dharma, Adharma kind of variations at all? That is not there outside of Pradhana. So Tadvyatirekena is Pradhana Vyatirekena. Other than Pradhana, Sahakari Antarasya. Sahakari Antarasya, any assistant cause, subsidiary cause, such as Dharma Dharma, are not there. Anavasthite Purushasya tu asanga udasinatvena pravruttav nivruttava anepeksha abhyupagamad ityartha. Abhyupagama means you yourself have accepted in your Sankhya Karika. This is your Mula Siddhanta, Sankhyas. As to Purusha is independent, he may be bhokta, but he is not karta. He has nothing to do with Pradhana. He has nothing to do with anything actually. So anapekshatva Abhyupagama in the case of pravritti or in the case of nivritti also. Whether the prapancha has to be created or destroyed or merged back, whatever have you, sthiti, purusha has nothing to do with it. Therefore, asanga, he is unattached, purusha, and udasina mean he is neutral. So he is unattached, but if at all you say, okay, the pradhana is going to create, do you have any objection or some role to play? He says, I have nothing to do. So purusha is completely disconnected and he has no interest in giving punya phala or papa phala. That is the udasinatvam. Udasinyam kim purushasya. He is neutral as to whether the punya phala has to be given or papa phala has to be given, it has not to be given, he has no say there. Therefore, not only he is unattached, he is also neutral to anything. He is completely, basically he doesn't care. So you can say he doesn't care. Udasinatva means that I don't care, what do you want to do? So thereby purushasya tu asanga udasinatvena pravruttav nivruttavva anapekshatva. There is no dependency in whatever sense that purusha will contribute to pradhana's creation. Therefore anapekshatva abhyupagamat. Anapekshatvat is what anapeksha abhyupagamat. You have accepted this. So I can use that as a hetu. Ityartha says the siddhanti. Nanu sahakarya bhavyapi pravruttir anyatra drishta ityataha. Purvapakshi sankhya says now, nanu sahakarya bhavyapi. Although there is no subsidiary cause, something like danda chakra for the kulala to use and convert mrit into ghata, they are all assisting his or aiding his ghata srishti. So ghata srishti, sahakari or danda chakra ityadi. Similarly, pradhana can have dharma dharma as sahakari. Now, it has been shown that sahakari is not possible. Sahakari karanas are not possible for pradhana because there is nothing other than pradhana except for purusha who is having nothing to do with your dharma dharma or pravritti nivritti or pradhana itself. So sahakari abhavyapi, purvapakshi says, although sahakari karanas are not there, pravritti anyatra drishta. So without the sahakari karanas also pravritti is seen elsewhere. So that way let the pradhana be jagat karana and have pravritti. That is refuted in the next sutra, fifth one, saying anyatra bhava chana trinadivat. Anyatra abhavat chana trinadivat. So anyatra abhavat cha na trinadivat. Trina is grass, the blade of grass. So trinadivat. Anyatra abhavat. So Purvapakshi is saying that without the sahakari karana. What is the sahakari karana? Abhava, meaning without the sahakari karana also there is pravritti seen. What is the example really? Here example is, he is saying trina, the blade of grass becomes milk. The blade of grass means glass, you can take grass itself. So grass becomes milk. We have seen the grass, the cow eats the grass and the there is no sahakari karana there. Where is the sahakari karana? Nothing else is needed. There is no processing, etc. There is no moving the grass and processing it in some form to get milk. Automatically, the grass converts itself into the cow's milk. The grass is eaten. It is all green. And then that grass becomes white also and becomes milk. So two ways you look at it, the grass becomes milk. And what kind of a grass, if you ask me, it is green grass. So its gunas also changed. So you cannot say, says the Purvapakshi to the Siddhanti, as to there is sahakari needed, there is no sahakari there. automatically the grass is converting itself within the cow's body and becoming milk. Green is becoming white also. So he is saying there no sahakari karana is needed. So why not pradhana become prapancha in this manner? So sutrakara says anyatra abhavaccha na trunadivat. You cannot use that example that truna has become kshira. If you think that truna has become trunadi, whatever you think has become something else without a sahakari karana, no, that is not so. Why? Pradhana is not like that. Why? Because in your example also anyatra abhavat. And due to cha and due to abhava, where is the abhava? This milk is not seen elsewhere, only in the cow it will be converted. Or basically in a particular kind of a body alone. So that is a sahakari. You cannot say that if at all it is true, then the bull will also start giving milk. So anyatra, anyatra means kasmad anyatra. Other than the gau. So other than the gau, other than the cow, you cannot see milk in bulls, etc. So that is the anyatra abhavat, kshirasya abhavat. So what the dhenu, you can take dhenvadehe, trunadivat dhenvadehe anyatra kshirasya abhavat. Dhenvadehe anyatra, or anything that is giving milk, if that is the example, then other than that kind of a gender also of that species, you do not see milk being produced elsewhere. Otherwise, without the sahakari, let it produce milk anywhere else. That doesn't happen. Therefore, what? Anya sahakrita pradhanam na jagat karanam. Anya asahakrita. Anya sahakrita pradhana can be jagat karana, but anya asahakrita. You say sahakari abhava means asahakrita. That pradhana which is without a sahakari cannot become jagat karana, just like trunadi also cannot become kshiradi without sahakari. So you see, only specific kind of a body of a specific species at a specific time in a specific condition will lead to milk. So all that is sahakari. Without such kind of a situation, the condition, milk won't be produced. So all that is sahakari. How did you miss that, says the Siddhanti? Trunadikam nimittantara nirapeksham eva kshirakarena parinamate tadvat pradhanam apiti chet na. Na is Siddhanti. Tiliti chet is Purvapaksha. What is he saying? Trunadikam. The truna ityadi haritamapi. Adikam haritamapi trunadi nimittantara nirapeksham eva, without any nimitta or sahakari karana, indeed it converts parinamate into kshira akara in the form of milk. Tadvat pradhanam apiti chit. Similarly, what pradhana also, without any dependency on anything, whether you are nimitta or sahakari, let it become the cause of this prapancha iti chet na. Siddhanti says not so. It is impossible. Why? Kutaha anyatra bhavat. Elsewhere there is no such darshana. If you give the example of dhenu, the cow, in which truna is becoming kshira, then other than dhenu you don't see in such species or such genders, you don't see the truna becoming kshira. So dhenuadi anyatra, other than the milk giving species, balivardado in bulls, etc., you do not see trunadehe kshira bhavasya abhava ityartha. The truna does not have kshira bhava. If you, what you are saying is that trunam kshira bhavam labhyate, or what you are saying that trunam kshira karana parinamate. So kshira bhava is prapta by truna. एंड तृणा आदिपदेन एनीथिंग दैट द काउ ईट्स ऑल दैट इज बिकमिंग मिल्क एज पर द पूर्व पक्षी ऑन इट्स ओन. सो तृणादेह क्षीर भाव से अभाव वेर इन दी इन बुल एटसेट्रा और अदर स्पीशीज वेर दे डू नॉट गिव मिल्क धीनवादे एंड दे स्टिल ईट they still eat the same food that the cow is eating. The bull is also eating the same food, but there it is not getting converted into milk. Dhinvadi sapeksham eva trinadikam kshiram bhavati. Only by dependency on the cow, goat, etc., which is she goat, there alone there is a conversion of grass, etc., eaten by that species into milk. Nirapekshatve balivardadam api kshirabhava prasangariti bhava. Otherwise, if you do not accept this dependency, then bulls also should be accepted as having milk. That is not true. Pradhanasya svatah pravruttim upetyapi dusheti. Now Purvapakshi is being answered by saying all your questions, our questions against Pradhana being Jagatkarana have not been answered by you, says the Siddhanti to the Sankhya Purvapakshi. And whatever possibilities you have presented, they have been refuted. Now let's just hypothetically assume. Hypothesis. So this is Abhyupagamavada. What is called as Abhyupagamavada? Hypothetically, let's assume that by some reason, discounting all these refutations that I have presented, let's just assume that Pradhana is Jagatkarana. What do you get out of it? You have to have some labha in your Siddhanta by Pradhana, which is Achetana, being known as Jagatkarana. Because your Sankhya is meaning that you also follow Jnana. Sankhya is also Jnana. So that Jnana should lead you to some labha. And what is that labha? Paramalabha is Moksha. Will this understanding of Pradhana as Jagatkarana lead you to Moksha? That is a question raised by Purvapakshi by taking hypothetically Pradhana as Karana. So Pradhanasya Svatah Pravruttim Upetyapi Dusheti. Let's just assume that Pradhana can move around on its own and become, change on its own, have Parinama and become Prapancha. Even then there is Dosha. There are defects in such a view. Hypothesis also leads to flaws, a flawed darshana. So the sutra, sixth sutra says abhyupagami apyartha bhavat. So abhyupagame api artha bhavat. Artha is really what? Purushartha bhavat. There is no purushartha siddhi by understanding pradhana as jagatkarana. Shruti says that एकेन कारणेन ज्ञानेन सर्वं ज्ञातं भवति. दैट इज व्हाट विल लीड टू मोक्ष. हियर नोइंग प्रधान जगत कारण विल नॉट लीड यू टू मोक्ष बिकॉज यू आर सेपरेट फ्रॉम प्रधान. इन युअर केस यू आर सेपरेट फ्रॉम दैट पुरुष ऑल्सो. इफ यू से दैट इफ वी ऑल्सो डिस्काउंट गिव सम डिस्काउंट्स टू युअर दर्शन एंड से दैट जीवा इज पुरुष एज पर दी श्रुति, स्टिल अंडरस्टैंडिंग प्रधान जगत कारण विल नॉट गिव यू विल फ्री दी पुरुष. Whether it is Supreme Purusha or the who does not need freedom, but the individual Jiva Purusha's level, you cannot have moksha by that jnana. So abhyupagami api, even if you accept pradhanasya svatah pravrutti abhyupagami api. So the pravruttim upetya means having accepted. Abhyupagama is having accepted, abhyupagama is acceptance, even if there is an acceptance. Abhyupagame sati. What acceptance is being talked about? So pradhanasya svataha pravrutti abhyupagami api. Even if there is acceptance, even when we accept the pradhana becoming karya on its own, having such kind of a pravrutti on its own, still what will happen? Api, even then, arthabhavat purushartabhavat, there will be no purushartha siddhi. Purushartasya abhavat, mokshasya abhavat. How so? The vritti explains, pradhanasya svatah pravrutti abhyupagami api, purushartasya apeksha bhava प्रसंगाद इत्यर्थः वॉट विल बी दि रिजल्टेंट इज दैट इवन इफ दि प्रधान इज हैव स्वतः बाय इट्सेल्फ हैविंग प्रवृत्ति यू एक्सेप्ट दैट अभ्युपगम्य अपि इवन देन व्हाट लेवल पुरुषार्थस्य अपेक्षा भाव प्रसंगात् पुरुषार्थ विल नॉट बी रिजल्टेंट व्हाई सो बिकॉज in your case you have yourself said that purusha also should be known you have to present your view in such a manner that your own darshana is not compromised and also moksha is which is the परम पुरुषार्थ फॉर एवरी दर्शन दैट ऑल्सो इज अटेन्ड सो पुरुषार्थ विच इज एक्सेप्टेड बाय ऑल दार्शनिकास एज मोक्ष परम पुरुषार्थ एंड एक्चुअली ओनली पुरुषार्थ पुरुषैः अर्थ्यते विच इज सॉट आफ्टर बाय ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दैट इज पुरुषार्थ वॉट इज रियली सॉट आफ्टर इज आनंद दैट इज द स्वरूप ऑफ मोक्ष सो दैट आनंद रूप मोक्ष पुरुषार्थ should be attainable by this pradhana swata pravritti because of what reason because na cheshtapati you cannot say it is okay it will be there purushartasya apeksha bhava prasangat there will be no expectancy of this moksha you cannot say okay that is agreeable why because na cha ishtapati ishtapati means samkhya says that okay this is desirable in our siddhanta she cannot say that why because pradhanam achetanam chetanasya purusharth sadhetumeva pravartate iti swabhyupagama virodhad iti bhavah If at all you say there is no dependency also ishtapatti moksha is attainable as per pradhana pravritti being on its own even in that case there is purushartha if you say then also there is an issue that is the refutation of ishtapatti because If at all the pradhana is creating on its own, then what is it attaining? Meaning what? See, basically you have to read something between the lines. So, your purusharthasya apeksha bhava prasanga ityartha, what is it really meaning is, I mean, what is the vritti really saying is that purushartha which is moksha, mokshasya apeksha abhavat, apeksha bhava prasangat, there will be a situation as to there is no dependency on moksha meaning to create this prapancha pradhanasya swata pravrutti abhyupagami api you have already we have accepted so we are saying that hypothetically we are accepting that pradhana is creating on its own without any dependency on purusha is your own siddhanta your own sankhya darshana so sankhya darshana says that purusha does not have any dependency nor has pradhana have any dependency on purusha to create If at all that is the case and pradhana is creating on its own then you will have accepted what is the resultant that you will have accepted what is the result result means that purushartha moksha apeksha is also not there moksha apeksha abhav prasangat meaning what pradhana is creating without any moksha as the goal but that is the resultant that is a corollary of such kind of a of an independent pradhana creation being the create pradhana being the karana independently the corollary of that would be what moksha is not the goal in the creation of pradhana independently but that is against your own sankhyavada how so That is why you cannot say Ishtapati. If we say that is the Prasanga, you say, oh yeah, it is all independent, Pradhana is independent, there is no site of moksha when Pradhana is creating. Purusha is moksha. But that is not true. Because your own Siddhanta is what, Darshana, your own Sankhya Vada is what, Pradhanam Achetanam, that Pradhana, although Achetana, is what? Chetanasya Purusha, that Chetana Purusha is Chetana. So, that Chetana Purusha has some artha, something to be attained. So, Chetanasya Purushartha Sadayatumeva, that Chetana Jiva, who is in by Swarupa, he is Purusha. May not be supreme, but he is Purusha. And Chetanasya Purushartha Sadayatumeva Pravartate iti Swabhyupagama Virodhatyartha. By Swapadena Sankhyavada. So, Sankhyavada Abhyupagama Virodhat. You yourself say in your own Darshana Shastras, Darshana Granthas, Sankhya Darshana Granthas, Karikadi, what do you say? You say that the reason that the Pradhana Achetana has Pravritti is to attain the Purushartha of the Chetana. So, to attain the Purushartha of the Purusha, the Artha of the Purusha, for that Pradhana has Pravritti. Why? Because Purusha is Shuddha Bhokta. Srishti is for the Bhoga of the Purusha. So, having said that Srishti is for the Bhoga of Purusha, which means that the Bhoga of the Purusha, which is what? Ananda in mind. There is Ananda in seeking the bhoga. No bhokta says that I want dukkha and then has pravritti. In your case, Purusha does not have pravritti at all. So, Purusha is a bhogi though. So, what kind of bhoga is he seeking after? Purusha is not seeking after dukkha bhoga. He is really seeking ananda bhoga. Thereby, Parama Ananda or Parama Bhoga is Moksha by Swarupa. So, that is really sought after by this Purusha being a Bhokta. Now, that Purushartha Siddhi is the reason for your Achetana Pradhana to have Pravritti in creation, creating Karya, Prapancha. So, which is true? Are you saying it is independent, Pradhana, which is creating Svataha, Pravritti, or is there a dependency on Purushartha of the Purusha? You cannot have it both ways. So, even if we accept Svataha Pravritti, there will be Purushartha Asiddhi. Because Pradhana will end up creating anything and everything without the Purushartha in mind. Meaning, Moksha, Purushaihi Arthyate. Or Purushena, you take individual also, Purushena, Archyate iti Purushartha, Moksha, Ananda Swarupa, Ananda Bhogaha, and your Purusha being Bhokta, Ananda Bhoga is sought after. That is his very Swarupa as to being Bhokta. Then how will he attain anything? Pradhana will create anything on its own, and then it has no sambandha with what Purusha expects. That is not what you have said in your own Karika. Your entire darshana falls apart. Therefore, Pradhanasya Svatah Pravritti Abhyupagamepi Purusharthasya Apeksha Bhava Prasanga Ityartha Nacha Ishtapatti Pradhanam Achetanam Chetanasya Purusharta Sadhetumeva Pravartate Iti Swabhyupagama Virodhad Iti Bhavaha. You will contradict your own darshana. That is why it is not acceptable as to Svatah Pravritti of Pradhana in Srishti, in creating the Karya. Then, Pura Pakshi says, Nanu, Purusha eva Swayam Apravartamano api Pradhana Pravartakasya Dityashankya Aha. Now, Pura Pakshi is taking another stance, which is also their own Vada. So, Purusha does not engage, he is a Bhokta. That is why he is only a Bhokta, he is not a Karta. So, their example I have mentioned earlier. Sankhyas give an example as to how is the Srishti, Pradhana, how does Pradhana become Jagatkarana and start the Srishti. For that, the example is that like a person, we take an example like a lady starts dancing at the sight of the beloved. So take an example like any Gopika. So Gopika at the sight of beloved Krishna starts dancing on her own. Does Krishna have anything to do with it? Krishna is not asking Gopikas to dance. Krishna is just bhokta. He looks at Gopikas, they are dancing, he is happy. He gets sukha. So he is bhokta. Just an example there, not to be taken literally and to its all its ends, but assume that. That kind of a scenario as to just in the presence of Krishna, who is beloved to Gopikas, take one Gopika, that Gopika starts dancing. What is the karana for the dance? Is the Purusha Krishna pushing Gopika to dance? No. But is Krishna bhokta there by watching over the dance of the Gopika? Yes. Similarly, Pradhana at the very sight, meaning as though sight, with the very presence, in the very presence of the Purusha, starts dancing this dance of creation. Just like a Tandava is mentioned as, you know, dissolution of the Prapancha, let's assume that the dance of the Pradhana is the creation of the Prapancha. Why is it so? Purusha is not Preraka, Purusha is not having Pravritti, Apravartamanaha api Purusha, the Swayam Apravartamana api Purusha. This Purusha has no Pravritti. So Swayam Apravartamanaha, he is not engaged. While not being engaged himself, what is Purusha doing? By the mere presence, Pradhana Pravartaka, he is prodding the Pradhana to create. How about that? So Nanu Purusha eva Swayam Apravartamana api. So Swayam Apravartamana api Purushaha Pradhana Pravartakasyat, Pradhanasya Pravartakasyat. He is the one who is prodding without actually engaging. In his mere presence, by his mere presence, he is making Pradhana to create as though. How about that? Iti Ashankya, why is that not possible? Pravartakasyat iti, Pradhana Pravartakasyat iti Ashankya Purushashmavaddhiti chet tathapi. Purushashmavaddhiti chet tathapi. So Purushashmavat iti chet tatha api. So Siddhanti says in the sutra, like the Purusha or Ashma. So examples are given, two examples are given. So Purusha is, you know, let's say a person is without legs. One, we know the story. Elsewhere we see, have heard this story. As to there are two friends. One is blind, the other one is without limbs, handicap. So the limbless friend cannot walk. Call him Chaitra. Maitra is blind, he cannot see, but he can walk. So Chaitra can see but cannot walk. Maitra can walk but not see. So what can happen? One who can walk, Maitra can walk. So Chaitra, who cannot walk but can see, can sit on the shoulders of Maitra. Maitra can walk, Chaitra can guide him as to where to walk. So that kind of a scenario is possible. Similarly here, Purusha is giving Prerana to Pradhana to walk, dance, create the Prapancha. So is the friend who is sitting on the shoulder Chaitra, is Chaitra actually walking? Chaitra is not walking. Therefore Purusha is not walking in the exemplified Chetana. Purusha is not walking. So who is walking? In the exemplified Pradhana is walking. In the example, Maitra is walking. So Maitra is equivalent to Pradhana. And Chaitra, who is sitting on the shoulders, who is blind, who is not walking, has no pravritti at all. He is just seeing. How about that example? So that is one example. Second is Ashmavat. So Purushavat is one example. Ashmavat is another. What is Ashmavat? Ashmavat means like a magnet attracting the iron pieces. So the magnet is attracting, the magnet is not really having any pravritti really. Whereas pravritti is there in the iron. So how about that? Purusha is equivalent to the magnet and the pradhana, which has pravritti, is equivalent to the iron pieces. So Ashmadivat is the Ashmavat. Ashmavat Purusha, Purushavat, Ashmavat iti chet. Tathapi, even then there is an issue. With those examples also you cannot prove how pradhana is jagat karana. So purushashmadivat or purushashmavat iti chet is what? Purushashmavat purusha pravruttam pradhanam jagat karanam iti chet. So purusha pravruttam purusha ashmavat purushavat ashmavat cha purusha pravruttam pradhanam jagat karanam iti chet. Tathapi, tathapi is a siddhanti, tathapi pradhanasya svatantrena karanatva bhavat pradhanam na jagat karanam. Independent pradhana is not jagat karana. Why? Because as soon as you say purushashmavat, in your example is there a dependency. So you have brought in dependency. This is exactly what you have been pointing out. You cannot say that pradhana is jagat karana and say that without being himself involved, purusha is prodding it to create. Your examples are showing the Maitra who is sitting on Chaitra's shoulders. Chaitra is sitting on Maitra's shoulders. Maitra is walking. Chaitra is sitting on. So whatever. I may have mixed up names. But the blind who is able to walk is Pradhana equivalent. And limbless or basically handicapped is sitting on the shoulder. But that handicapped can see. One who is able to see is telling, involving himself in guiding the blind to walk. Therefore, that kind of an involvement will be there for Purusha. If you say he is not himself involved, then also there is dependency. Some dependency is there. So your example is showing dependency. There also there is a dependency. Similarly, exemplified also there will be dependency. If you accept dependency of any type, we will tell you that Pradhana is not independent creator. And with dependency on Purusha, if it is a creator, we have no issues, because indirectly it will mean Ishvara. You may not accept the terminology and you cannot agree with what I am saying, but it will mean, finally it will end up meaning the same thing. So I'll just finish this vritti because I have already explained. So loke yatha panguhu purusha swayam apravartamano api ayam anyam andham pravritti shaktimantam pravartayati. Just like a blind leads the handicapped one bereft of legs who cannot walk to walk, you need the blind. So blind is walking, but the handicapped use prerana. Although he is himself swayam apravartamano api anyam andham, he makes the blind, who is another person, pravritti shaktimantam, who is able to walk, run as well, pravartayati, he, the handicapped, prods the other blind friend to walk. Yathava ayaskanto ashmas sannidhi matrena ayah pravartayati. Thereby a second example has been given. The magnet without itself moving can make the iron pieces, small iron pieces move. Evam purusha pravartaka iti chet. Similarly, this purusha is one who prods the pradhana to create iti chet. If that is the case, tathapi. Even then what will happen? Pradhanasya purusha preryatve sati. Then when you accept pradhana, he is having the prerana from purusha to create. Svatantra abhyupagama virodaha. In your system you have said that there is svatantraya of pradhana in creation, there is no more independency, it is dependent. Purushasya pravartakatve kautasthya hanihi ityadi doshanam anirmokshaha. further what will happen? Further, not only is that an issue, but the Purusha is making Pradhana engage, therefore Kautasthyahani. Purusha is no longer Kutastha. Kute tishtati iti Kutavat tishtati. Kutavat tishtati iti Kutastha. One who is like a Kuta. Unmovingly he is steady. He is still. He is present without movement. That is the Kutastha Purusha. Then this Kutastha Purusha will no longer be there. Thereby what will happen? Kautasthya Hani. Purushasya Kautasthasya Hani. Ityadi Doshanam Anirmoksha. And thereby there will be no moksha. Because Purusha is really engaged, then what kind of a moksha will he have? One who is really moving, really having pravritti, that Purusha cannot have moksha at all. Anirmoksha prasanga. There will be no nitya moksha. It will appear like moksha, again he'll start moving. Because one who has moved once can move again. But Purusha is one who has never moved. He is unchanging. That unchanging Purusha appears to be having changes and therefore becomes a samsari jiva. And Siddhanta Shruti says that this jnana as to I have never been changing, I have always been Kutastha, unchanged Purusha, Brahma, Parabrahma, that is moksha. But if I have had any change and now I'll become changeless, that is not possible. One who is having change can never become changeless. So therefore, anir moksha prasanga. Brahmanastu, then that is the same dosha in your case. If you say, if the Sankhya says that, oh, in Vedanta, what is the solution? You'll have the same problem. So Brahmanastu avidyakam pravartakatvam iti na kautasya hanihi. In our case, we don't have that problem. Why? Because Brahmanatu pravartakatvam is avidyakam. Brahma by its very presence makes maya create, is our Siddhanta. Maya becomes upadana karana and the reflected one Chaitanya in Brahma appears to be the creator and the change element, samsari also. So all that prapancha, the jiva, all the prapancha, all the jiva, all the jivas, all they are having sambandha also and having pravritti, having karma phala. So karta, bhokta, all the karakas, all of them are what? Avidyakam. Avidyakam means avidya karya. Since they are avidya karya and kalpita, meaning is kalpita, they are all appearances, there is only vikshepa, but there is no real change, it is all vivarta. So brahmanastu pravartakatvam avidyakam iti krutva na kautasthya hanihi. There is no compromise on the changelessness of Brahma. Brahma has never changed. By avidya, by the veiling of avidya, there is an appearance. There is an appearance of pratibimba. Pratibimba appears to be moving. See, the sun does not have to move for the reflection to move. Why? Because water is unsteady. The reflection in the water, multiple water body shows multiple moons or suns reflecting, and the sun also seems to be unstable, the moon also seems to be unstable in the unsteady water. The water is unstable, unsteady, the reflection seems to be changing, but neither has the reflection really changed, nor has the bimba, the original, changed. What has changed is the water. Water is moving. The reflection appears to be moving, and thereby we misunderstand that the original is moving. Therefore, Brahmanastu avidyakam pravartakattvam iti na kautasthyahani. We look at the 8th sutra in the next part. Amrayantika samsiddha mahadi madhyant varjita mahananda harama purnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Tatsat namaste, dhanyavada.